All right, so we are live for the first time in Centerville, Ohio. Ooh, how exciting. We are going to work on Alley Dock, and Catherine will be joining me in a moment. For right now, I'm going to explain the setup. Christian, this is for you. So we're going to show you the setup of how you kind of want to position yourself to make this happen. Okay, so I'm going to turn the camera around so you can see what I'm talking about, and then we'll go from there. And as soon as Catherine joins us, then I will have her demonstrate and we'll go through the process kind of step by step. So here we go. Okay, I'm going to turn it around. Like I said, bear with me. It's the first time going live. I know. Ooh, exciting. All right. So here's our alley dock. As you can see, we have cones on the right-hand side. There's, they represent a wall, okay, per se. So we want to make sure that no part of our bus ever crosses the plane of that wall, okay? All right. So if you then look to the left-hand side, I'll try to pan out so we can see the whole picture. So on the left-hand side, then we have the parking box, okay? So when we position ourselves, we want to position ourselves not completely center between the two sets of cones. We want to position ourselves so that we are favoring the right-hand side. And you're going to be approximately 20 feet from the cones on the right-hand side of the parking space. Okay, if you park closer to the parking box, it's going to be more challenging to get yourself into that box. It'll give you plenty of room on the right-hand side when you're swinging your front end around, but it's going to be more challenging to get into that parking space. Okay, so we want to make sure that we give ourselves enough space on both sides. Hoping that makes sense. All right, now the next step here, try to have as little downtime as we can. I know this is live, so we have to kind of keep things moving as much as we can. As we get on the bus, I'm going to kind of show you a few things right here. Okay, so we want to make sure that our mirrors are set by Federal Motor Vehicle Safety Standards. Okay, and I'll try to give you an idea of what that will look like. All right, your crossover mirrors should be at a 45 degree angle from the bus, and you should be, when they're set properly, you should be able to see, if you're looking from the rear of the bus, about half of that mirror peeking out as you're peering down the side of the bus. Same with on the other side, okay? You should be able to see the front portion of your bus 10 feet in front of it and all the way to the right or left, depending on which mirror you're looking at. Your top mirror, you should be able to see all the way down the side of the bus, and the little rain gutter on top. And as we look in this mirror and we're looking at the alley dock maneuver, we should be able to see, and it's kind of hard to see it in this, there we go, we have the two cones in the upper left corner, or sorry, the lower, I'm not even looking in the right mirror, sorry. As we look at this, we're looking at the lower left mirror, and we want to be able to see the cones in the upper left corner of our mirror. And I'm going to try to get a better view for you on this. Thank you for your comments. That's very, very sweet. All right. I need to get rid of them, though. Okay. Happens to be right in my mirror. Okay. So, as we're looking at this, we need to see the mirror. See the cones right there in the upper left corner of the mirror? There we go. That's what we want to see. And we're going to go straight back until the two cones just about disappear. And I'm going to have Catherine demonstrate this, but I wanted to give you an idea of what that should look like and where it's going to be on your in your visual stream, okay? All right, so I'm going to pan out here again. Okay, so I'm going to have Catherine sit down, and I'm going to kind of walk through this process with you so you can see how it's done and what we're looking for, and hopefully I'll be able to give you a decent demonstration, or Catherine will give you a lovely demonstration. Hopefully I will be able to show you what to look for to make things a little bit easier for you to do this. Of course, things are going to be a little different for whomever is doing this based on how you sit in the vehicle, how your mirrors are adjusted, and because you know we're all taller or shorter, or and how we view things is also going to make a difference. Okay, so Kathy is ready to go here. We always make our drivers have the hazard lights on and beep before we back. Sometimes when you're taking exams in different state locations, they don't want you to beep until you've completed the maneuver. So just make sure you always check with your local test site to see what those specifics are. Okay, so here is, I'm not sure what we're seeing here. It's hard to see. Let's see if I can comb in. There we go. All right, go ahead and start backing, Kathy. It's not easy to do. You want to go straight back with this. Again, brakes are wet. That's why we're having those ugly noises. It's not a pretty day here in Centerville, Ohio. Live feed is fun, isn't it? Okay. All right. Okay, so again, this is, go ahead, Kathy, just go ahead and do the maneuver. I'm probably gonna have to end up being outside so you can see what is going on. Once you start turning your wheel, you wanna make sure that you start looking in your opposite mirror. You wanna start looking in the lower right mirror so you can see those cones behind you when they come into view. When they come into view, particularly that back one, you're gonna straighten your wheel and go just in between both. You'll have to look in both sets of mirrors, one side and the other, to make sure that that you're centered between them. You wanna be centered between these two cones. Wow, as soon as these brakes, there we go. And we're gonna stop the bus when our cones visually look like they are aligned. I don't know, so you see that? It kind of looks like it's right visually next to that turn signal. See how it visually aligns there? That's what we want to see. That way we know that we're about 3 feet away from the back of the parking space box. And that's how we're going to do that, okay? All right, so let's get out and take a look. And we're going to do that again from the outside so you can see what it looks like from the outside as well. I'll turn this camera around for just a minute, or go ahead and open that door for me. Like I said, live action fun. Okay, here we go. I always feel like I sound like a big personality-less robot when I do this. So let's see if we can make it a little better here. So here we are. So we would want to stop a little bit sooner because that's a little bit too far back, okay? Now, the good news about this is when you encroach on a parking space like this in Ohio, this isn't for the state of Ohio, you get the opportunity to get back in your bus and fix the problem, okay? Again, please make sure that this is the case with your state and what their requirements are and what they will allow and what they will not allow, okay? Okay, so Catherine, I'm gonna have you do this again, and I'm gonna stay on the outside. And we'll kind of take a look at it from the outside so what we can see. There's Kathy. Hey. Okay. She's another awesome Centerville trainer here. Okay. I'll turn this around. Is she gonna get set up? All right, so we'll have her get set up in just a minute here. Okay, I'm gonna show you again, for those of you that may have missed it. When we're setting up, and here, you may not have a visual that kind of we have here. We wanna make sure, again, like we are about 25 feet away from the right-hand side of the alley dock parking space, okay? All right, and she's going to get set up now. Are we having fun yet? Okay, Christian, I hope these tips are helping, and let me know. I'd love to hear if this is beneficial, because if it is, maybe we'll consider doing some more. We've never done this before, so it's a first, like I said. All right, so here she goes. So here's Catherine getting set up. Turn this camera around. I'm gonna try to give you the best possible view here. My camera skills might not always be the stellar, but we work with what we have, okay? All right, so as you can see, she's about 20 feet away from the right-hand side of the alley dock parking space. And here she goes. Hazard lights on, beeping before she backs. Okay, she's going to go straight back. Sometimes the other reference point that you can use is to when the bumper of the bus looks like it is adjacent to the cones on the left, you can also start to turn as well then, okay? All right. Then she's gonna look in her lower right-hand mirror as she's backing, and those two cones on the right come into view. And she will back until that turn signal almost appears to be adjacent to the cones, okay? And again, this visual reference might vary based on how you view things in mirrors. Okay. You never want to go behind the cones to see the whole bumper. That will definitely bring you too close to the back of the parking space. Okay, and we'll check out her position. She is definitely within that alley dock box. Much better positioning. That's exactly what we want to see. All right. Well, I hope this has been very helpful for anyone watching. We appreciate all of you. And we hope you all have a very happy
New Year.
Camera issues. Happy New Year, guys.
Happy New Year, guys.
Bye.